Do you want to know how the next generation of hustlers are turning their dreams into dollar signs? I'm Matt James, and this is Riser Diaries from TurboTax Studios, where we get real about money moves being made by today's boldest game changers breaking barriers and redefining what success really means. Welcome, Riser Nation. Today, we're talking to Angel Reese, who's a beast both on and off the court. Angel, also known as Bayou Barbie, is not only a star on LSU's iconic basketball team, she's also earning big on NIL deals, putting her in the top 10 of all collegiate athletes. And when she's not inking deals or draining threes, she's building her brand by captivating audiences through her content across all of her heavily trafficked platforms. Angel is truly paving the way for other women athletes to make their own money moves. And I can't wait to hear more about how she went from a hooper in Maryland to a top-earning sports world game changer. Angel, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here.
Yeah, we're excited to have you. All right, Angel, you're setting all kinds of records on the court while making big business moves off the court. But before you became the superstar you are today, you were a kid shooting hoops in Maryland with your brother in the driveway. How did all that factor into where you're at now as a hooper?
Okay, well, I started playing basketball when I was younger, about 4 years old. It was always just me and my brother playing. And then my mom was a coach. So we played when we were younger. We had a court in front. We were super competitive. My mom had to take the basketball hoop from outside of the front of the yard because we used to like compete so hard and like go at it and kill each other. Yep. So it was so much fun. I mean, growing up playing basketball, I'm from Baltimore. So I played on outside courts. High school, I went to St. Francis with my brother. Started my freshman and sophomore year at the University of Maryland, which was fun. Going to school with my brother was fun. But then I finally decided to take a step away and go to LSU, and it had been the best decision of my life.
If I asked your brother who the better hooper was, who's the better hooper? We got a family of hoopers. Who would you say is the better hooper?
I'm gonna say myself, of course. Okay, let me say, like, I feel like I'm better in like women's basketball, but like if he was, of course, to play women's basketball, he would kill us because he's so much stronger and bigger than us. But like he would beat me probably 1-on-1, but like I'm dominant in women's basketball.
Talk to me.
You know what I'm saying?
Talk to me. I feel that. What factored into that move going from and transitioning from Maryland to LSU? And did it have anything to do with the NIL taking place right now?
Yeah, actually, I had nothing to do with NIL. When I actually was at Maryland, I was doing a little bit of NIL, but I didn't know how much money women could make because women really weren't making that much money. Transitioning into LSU, I wanted something better for my career as far as just translating to the WNBA, working on things to get me ready for that. And of course, Kim Mulkey, as you guys know, she has a history of putting players in the pros and winning championships. So I wanted to go somewhere where I can win, help continue a legacy there. Simone Augustus, Sylvia Fowles had gone to LSU and just trying to build a program back up to where it was. I knew I wanted to go to the SEC for sure. It's love down south. I already knew it was going to be love down south, but LSU just happened to be home.
As a kid, how did you imagine the earning potential in basketball for you now that you're in college?
I never thought it was anything. I never even thought about athletes getting paid in general, even men. I mean, I knew men could be one and done easily out of college easier than women, and we had to go at least 3 years. So I really never had a thought of that. I mean, you know, we get our cost of attendance check every month, so that's what I was looking forward to, especially for sure. My freshman year, and that was just the money that was in my pockets. But it's been great. I mean, I never imagined this as I was younger.
What was your relationship like with money before you got to school versus, you know, having established yourself now and making a little bit of money?
Yeah, I was always good with saving. I mean, my grandma kind of taught me younger, like, to save a lot of money. You never know when it's going to be a rainy day. So when I got to Maryland and I started just getting those little bitty checks, I was already saving. Like, I wasn't spending like crazy, OD. You never know when you need it, and you never know when you could lose everything. So even like my grandma, like, she always like, I have a lot of money and stuff like now, but like she'll still give me like $40 just to like keep that in a sock, like just for a rainy day. You know how grandparents
are.
Yeah,
for sure. And when did you think it was necessary to take that step and be like, I need someone to help me manage in my money?
Actually, I just got my financial advisor this summer.
Let's go.
Me and my brother got him this summer because everything had hit Emmy once, all at once. So I didn't know I needed it. My mom was more on it. She was like, you need to do the 401k. You need to be doing tax. You need to make sure the money is going the right places, because I was having to pay so much in taxes, especially last year, and not even understanding like an LLC and doing all that stuff, putting everything in my business name and doing stuff like that really, really, really helped me. And especially paying taxes this January really helped me.
Yeah, let's stick on the taxes for a second. What was it like when that first tax bill came due?
I was so upset last year when I had to pay taxes for the first time. I'm like, why are they taking all my money?
Right.
Yeah, and I didn't even realize like I have to save and put money to the side, like not just for myself, but for the taxes. Like this money I'm not going to see again. So I was sad the first time, but I mean, you don't want the IRS coming after you. So I'm going to pay them. I'm going to pay what I got to pay.
Hey, Angel, the IRS is undefeated.
They don't play.
Are you having these same type of conversations with your teammates?
Yeah, these conversations are must-have conversations, but our school, LSU, does a really great job. We have a program called NILSU, and they help us with making sure we file our taxes and when money is going through, the W-9s, making sure we're filling that stuff out. So they really help us. And that's something that also I wasn't aware of when I came to LSU. Like, I didn't tell them I wanted to set up a meeting about the NIL stuff, but they set a meeting up with me about that stuff too, which really stuck out to me.
TurboTax experts make your moves count. Filing with 100% accuracy and getting your max refund guaranteed. See guarantee details at TurboTax.com/guarantees. Experts only available with TurboTax Live. What do you think the potential for NIL is for young women like you coming up and like your teammates and going forward?
I think the sky's the limit. I mean, you can see in sports, like you don't even have to be the best athlete on your team. Mm-hmm. You can literally just have that notice, that face, something that gets people's attention. And it could be the smallest thing, TikTok, Instagram. And I always even tell my friends, like, it's so many ways to make money these days. It's crazy. Like, people go viral for the craziest things. Right. And I think, like, that's something I've kind of told my teammates, like, have your own little thing. Like, have your own name. Have something that's different from other people. Because if everybody's having the same thing going on, I don't think that we're not all going to make the same amount of money. So just trying to kind of be different and bring your own little niche to things, I think that that'll really help women in sports.
I love that. I love that. Before you had a financial advisor, who were you going to for financial advice?
My mom is huge on saving money. Of course, as a mom that is independent and a single mother growing up, raising two kids, of course, she understood what it took to save money and making sure that you survive off whatever. And I think she kind of understands that. So I always kind of look to her and to help me with things. She always says, make sure your credit score is right, making sure you're not owing on bills, making sure your bills are paid on time. Like, she always handled that stuff for me. Like my freshman year when I got to college, like I started paying my own phone bill, but she was like, making sure you're on it, make sure you're on it, make sure you're on it, like, and make sure you're not late with those bills and making sure you're not getting extra fees, because that will really affect you in the long run. And she has shared experiences that she had when she was like in college and those negative things that happened to her. So, yeah.
Okay, Angel, it's no secret that you've got a lot of stuff going on. Is there a key partnership that stuck out to you when you were pursuing all these NIL deals?
Well, my number one thing was like fashion and like beauty. Like, I've always been into fashion and beauty. That's always been my big things. My first ever NIL deal was Starface. And there were like these pimple patches that you put on your face. And a couple of us basketball girls were doing it when I was a sophomore at Maryland. And that was my first deal. And I loved it. Like, I remember, I still have some of the videos. I might have them up still on my Instagram. But like, I just enjoy, like, I could be a content creator. Like, I love doing this and just having fun with it. But like, all my NIL deals, I try to like incorporate the fashion and beauty thing, because when I'm not playing basketball, like, that's just what I do. Like, that's just who I am.
As you mentioned earlier, you're so versatile, and I'm sure you get a million opportunities and people knocking at your door to do every type of deal. Are there things that you turn down and you are selective about what you want to do?
Yeah, sometimes, sadly, I have to turn down some things. One, because it doesn't just fit into my schedule. Like, I can't do it, especially if it's somewhere I have to fly. I can't fly during the season just because, I mean, I'm focused about being here at LSU. So everything on my Instagram is basically not basically, but actually it's authentic to who I am. Like, everything is on there. I don't put anything on my social media that isn't, like, true to who I am and that I actually really like.
Can you walk me through what it was like when that first NIL check hit and you were like, what was your response? How did you feel?
Well, I had been making some good money before, like, the national championship game. I was making some good money. Probably after the championship is when everything just started hitting the fans. Everything was going. Luckily, it sucks because I don't like, everything on social media. Like, I don't know how people think that they can count my money in my pockets, like, thinking they know how much money I'm making.
Right.
So, I don't spend a lot of money. I do, like, nice stuff. I like jewelry and I like bags and stuff, but I don't go crazy.
So you talk about getting a big house eventually. Are these the type of conversations you're having with your financial advisor, or how do you manifest that?
Well, I got a car and I like my car. I love my car, but electric cars are not the best, especially in Baton Rouge, because there's not a lot of charging stations. So I wanted to turn my car in and I wanted to get a new car and I wanted to get a G-Wagon. But he was like, just wait a second. You just got to slow down. Like, just wait a second. Wait till your lease is up. And then he was like, the price that they were trying to offer me was like crazy. I was like, all right, I'll do it. Let's do it. Let's get it. And then I ran it by him. He was like, nah, like, we're not doing that. Like, yep. You're going to have to wait. Like, you're going to have to wait a couple months. And I was trying to get it like last month. I already had told the dealership, yeah, I'm getting it. Like, I'm like, bring the car up here. I'm getting it. Once I ran it through him, he was like, nah, we're not getting it. It's like, the price that you're paying on this car, you can get a house. So yeah, I've had the conversations, like, hopefully whenever I decide to leave LSU, like, I'm able to buy a home, be a homeowner. I've always wanted to, like, buy a house and, like, flip it and, like, Airbnb it. I've always wanted to do that back home in Baltimore, because when I go home, like, I don't want to stay in my mom's house. I want to stay somewhere else. I want to stay, like, in a house where I can have by myself. So yeah, I do have these kinds of conversations with my mom and my advisor.
So after having that conversation with your advisor, did it make sense to to take a pause on it?
Yeah, it made sense, because I could have been bankrupt.
How do you balance everything, Andrew? You have a million things going on. You've got school, you've got hoops, you've got these deals. Like, how do you find time to manage all these different things you're working on?
Yeah, my team is amazing. I mean, having my mom on my team, of course, she's perfect. Hopefully soon I can retire her. And hopefully she can be full-time. Janine, I've been working with Janine for, what, going on 3 years now. She's been great. And having a lawyer, that's been amazing. My financial advisor is amazing. I have a small team. Unlike a lot of people, I'm not signed to an agency. Mm-hmm. That's something that has been different for a lot of athletes. And a lot of athletes always ask me, like, how does that work for you? And I think it really just works for me because, I don't know, agencies are kind of hard. It's kind of tricky. I just love the team that I have for myself, and just being able to help grow that team over these past, 12 months has been crazy.
And now look at where you are today. You've overcome tax curveballs and climbed your way to the top, gaining all this wisdom along the way. I'd love to know how you're planning on flexing that knowledge and what you're doing next.
Well, definitely becoming a homeowner, okay, for sure. I really don't know. I'm still young. Like, I'm 21. Like, I don't be thinking about these things just yet. Right. Like, I do want to flip houses. Like, I really want to get into, like, understand, like, real estate stuff. I'm really interested in that market, because I see, like, a lot of that going on. I don't know. TikTok kind of helps me look at some of those things that
low-key.
I like. I just want to be an entrepreneur and, like, just have as many businesses as I can. Of course, it's all after I play the WNBA. I mean, that's my number one goal. And hopefully whenever that time comes, I'm able to be ready for that. But, like, in the off season, like, that's just what I want to do. And also, I model as well, too. Mm-hmm. So I have a couple of things I'm doing, and okay, I'm just trying to balance it all together.
You're doing so much, and there's so many things that you're adding into your financial journey. Is there anything that's pivotal to that success that stands out the most in terms of what do you think setting you up for future success?
I think my versatility, like, me being able to be, like, who I am and standing on who I am and, like, not backing down. I think that's why people kind of love me, because, like, I am who I am on and off the court. I'm girly. I like to get my nails done, hair done, all that stuff on the court. But I'm also a dog. Like, I like to win. I like to get down, and I want to win. Like, I want to do whatever it takes to win. So I really reach a lot of different kind of audiences, black, white, girls, boys. Like, I reach a lot of different kinds of people. And I think my impact is something that I really, like, have looked at in a different perspective. Like, if all else was were to fail and I wasn't able to play basketball anymore, I know I've left my impact. I know I've done something great for people in the younger generation, the older generation, and so many different kinds of people. And that's all I really ever wanted to do. Like, of course I want to be the best player. Of course I want to do all these things, but you don't really see a lot of women, Black women, being able to leave their impact at such a young age and just doing what I'm able to do and inspire so many people. So I think regardless of anything I decide to do, I'll always know that I was able to impact somebody's life.
Mm, I love that. You launched the Angel Reese Foundation in August of 2023 in your home state of Maryland. Can you run us through what inspired you to start that foundation?
Well, first, I went to St. Francis in Baltimore, small Catholic school in the hood, across the street from a jail. And in high school, I always said, like, I wanted to make a scholarship, and I wanted to have a scholarship that I could give back and pay for somebody's scholarship, one of the players on the basketball team. Because when I was at St. Francis, somebody had paid for my scholarship, one of the donors. So I was like, I'm going to give back because St. Francis made me who I am. They've done such an amazing job and putting me into positions where I am right now, and I wouldn't be where I am without them. So I was like, let me do that. I was like, I want to just start a scholarship. And then my financial advisor was like, yeah, we should start a foundation as well. Like, we can do a lot of things as far as just trying to go into communities, not just in Baltimore, but also Baton Rouge as well, and just trying to impact as much as we can, offering financial literacy to younger girls, empowering women, and just kind of giving them what it looks like and that they have a chance to do what I'm doing. So I think that kind of really started there, of course, with the scholarship. And then since then it's taken off. I've done some two back to school events. I've gone into like stores and bought kids some school supplies and buy them shoes for school as well. So I did something for Christmas as well here in Baton Rouge as well. So just doing as much as I can for the community, and they really love it.
Wow. I mean, it's no secret why you're so successful. I mean, you're paying it forward. You're conscientious.
Thank you.
You think about others. It's just amazing to see someone in your position doing stuff like that. That's awesome.
Thank you.
All right, Angel, you've made a fair amount of money right now. Looking back at your younger self and athletes on the rise to where you want to be, what type of advice would you give them in terms of how to set themselves up for success and things that they might not know about taxes and conversations that you're having with your financial advisor?
One thing I wish I did start was probably an LLC. I think honestly, just having a financial advisor is something that I really, really encourage for people to do and get if they can. But also just trying to start that LLC. I think that's just super important. Being able to write stuff off, using that business credit card for certain things and certain purchases, and just being smart with your money. I mean, you can't buy every bag and you can't buy everything you want, you see all the time. So planning out a lot of things and setting yourself up for a budget, I think, is also important.
And how do you teeter that line of being smart with your money and enjoying the fruits of your labor, but also planning for the future?
If I can't buy it twice, I don't buy it.
Ooh,
I try not to buy it. Even sometimes if I have to wait 2 months, 3 months for it, it'll be worth the wait. But just doing whatever it takes to maximize as much as I can for this NIL stuff, because it's at our hands right now. I think that we're in a time where you can make so much money in a short amount of time, and enjoying college as much as you can. It's been great, and touching so many different kinds of people and making an impact is just something that's been great for me.
If Angel Reese wasn't hooping right now, what would she be doing?
I would be modeling. I'll probably be overseas somewhere, probably like in London or Paris or something.
Ooh, okay.
Just like shopping. I could see myself shopping with my Yorkie.
Is that a trip that you're manifesting? Or do you have plans to go to?
Yes, I put that on my vision board. I want to go to Paris this year. I really want to go to, I want to go to Fashion Week in Paris. I don't think I'm going to be able to go this year. I don't know. I'm not sure yet though.
You're 21. I can only imagine you will have multiple opportunities to participate in and be around that experience whenever you have the time with sports. I know it's difficult. Okay, Angel, if there was a investment that you've made in yourself that you're making for the future, what would you say is something prominent that sticks out to you?
Probably my nutrition, just being able to train. I mean, look at LeBron James. He spends millions of dollars on his body and he's playing at a very older age than you would expect.
Right.
So I want to be able to play as long as I can. So being able to hire trainers, nutritionists, being able to just have the right people around me to keep me where I am right now and get even better. Being able to have to fly out trainers to work me out here and just being able to just have that stuff that's accessible. I mean, college has done a great job for me being able to have these things for free around here, but sometimes I do need to fly out and I need someone to fly here to work with me and work me out or do certain things like that.
And people not in your position don't understand that that actually is an investment. You're investing
in
yourself.
Yeah, that is an investment. Yeah. You spend more money than you think on those certain things.
And there you have it, folks. Angel Reese, Bayou Barbie, activist, entrepreneur, model, riser. Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Y'all, I am blown away. Angel Reese is, I mean, everything I wanted to be yesterday. And she's 21. She's just a prime example that it's never too early to start planning. I mean, personally, I was taking notes, I mean, mental notes, and I can't wait to hear the wisdom shared from all of our guests this season. Until then, I hope you guys are on the rise. Riser Diaries is an Intuit TurboTax podcast presented by TurboTax Studios and produced by Frequency Media. I'm your host, Matt James. Our executive producer is Michelle Corey. Our producer is Lizzie Stewart. Our associate producer is Sara Naz Jadbabayu. Concept strategy and development by Michelle Corey and Jessica Olivier. Our engineer, editor, and mixer is Claire Bittigary Curtis. Video editing by Julian Andrew K.A.